Watch the house, big fella. You need some time without the youngsters. Watch your house and relax. Good boy. Man, he's like a statue. He knows exactly what he's got to do, and he knows I'm only not taking him to give him a little break. He doesn't need any. He needs no improvement. Nothing. You having fun, Polly? Please tell me this isn't your favorite tune. You know, it's not that bad. Kind of like this song. You know? Who doesn't like Taylor Swift? What do you think, Paul? We can do this. We can do it. I'm not sure. I should probably pay attention to where I'm going. What the heck was that? Oh. Break it down for him, Paul. What's up? Now this is Paul's song. Just a couple of deer that are dying to survive. Oh, look at you looking at us there. I can see you. We see you. Oh boy, folks. This is when me and the Furbs, we pack up. We were gonna come out and do some work here, but this is what happens in hard winters, and the snow is so deep that these deer can't get away. Look at all the raven tracks and the birds, and that's what calls all the stuff, all the predators. Look at that trail from the wolves coming to and from to feed. We're gonna have to get the hell out of here. We can't stick around. Those wolves are not far, especially when it's this deep of snow. Well, we're going somewhere else.
Well, I don't know, guys. The ice dam here on the Cloquet River. Oof.
Easy walking, but we got to be careful. We're some heavy fellows.
It must be the highway up there, the old number 7 up there. What do you think, Harry?
Paul!
Okay.
we'll cross here, guys. There's really no way. Maybe we won't. There's really no way around. Much easier walking. Just gotta be careful. Wow. What do you think, Harry? Let's go. Paul. Come on, guys. Ooh. Some chunky stuff here. Whoa. Come on. Oh, there's like a skating rink up here. Come on, guys. It's safe. Come on. There's some thin stuff here. Hey. Why do we do this? Why do we do this? Long live the fur beetles. There's kind of an echo under here. I'm so glad I'm taking you guys with me in case I plunge in. Come on. It's all clear. It's safe. Don't you trust me, guys? Oh, boy. That's open water up there. How close do we? I think that was close enough. I think we're close enough to that little open spot. Come on, Paul. Come on. Look at Paul the dweeb. Way, way over there. Quit being a dweeb. What do you think of dweeby? Is he a dweeb? Yep. Paul's a dweeb. Come on. We gotta get across here, Polly. Let's go. Okay, because of Paul, we're taking the long way. But maybe he had a good idea, because there's quite a bit of open water there. Maybe it saved us, Polly, huh? But, you know, if the ice held me and Harrison, I think you were going to be all right. But I guess... Oh, God. Oh. Thanks, Harry. That was nice. That was great.
Oh boy, here comes a train up there. pull Big Daddy up the hill. Pull me right on up that bad boy. Oh, I gotta get in better shape here, folks. Cripes. Woo. So one thing led to another, folks, and we ended up way out of our comfort zone. I'm too lazy to do this. I really am. That is some deep snow. It tests the cardio to the limits on the boys and me. Woo, doggy! I'll tell you, that train was loud. That was crazy. It's cool to see how they reacted and stuff too, to insurmountable noise. They got a little squirrely, but handled it well. They were on point, ready to go. And that's a big foe, a train. So, Paul, we couldn't get him out on the ice. He must have knew something we didn't. So we had to head back. Now we're heading home and off to go pick up my kids and on for another adventure tomorrow. Like, subscribe, hit the bell. Some cool stuff gonna happen. And I don't want you guys to miss it. Thanks again. Bye. So in regards to the day, there were deer all over, coming to roads, trails, just everywhere. And I didn't know why until we got into it a little bit. And, you know, that's what a responsible dog owner does. You see, the wolves own the woods. We don't. And they're not going to be far from the very little bit of food source they have. However, they can walk on top where deer cannot. And it's almost like a McDonald's out there for them. So wolves are having a great winter, deer are not. And my primary concern is to get my dogs safe because they're not afraid of the big bad wolf, and that's the issue. So, and then their job is to protect me. So the only way I can negate it is to leave, turn around and go. And their urge to protect me even stops the urge to eat the deer carcass, which I don't like them doing either. Just communicable diseases and other things, but we had a crazy day, and now we know why there were deer all over. Them wolves weren't far, so crazy day.